President Trump says he thinks the press makes him seem like less of a nice guy than he really is. My panel is back. Here's President Trump addressing his public image earlier today.
I think the press makes me more uncivil than I am. You know, people don't understand. I went to an Ivy League college. I was a nice student. I did very well. I'm a very intelligent person. I think the press creates a different image of Donald Trump than the real person.
I'm sorry.
This is why he teaches you, Don.
No, to cap it off, he spoke to himself in the third person. Once again, it's the press's fault. Bakari,
lightning round.
I completely understand what Donald Trump is going through, because everybody on Twitter, I mean, half the people on Twitter, they have a different image of me, but I'm an incredibly smart person. I went to an historically black college or university, and I was a very, very nice student, Don. So I think I understand what Donald Trump is talking about.
All right. Well, let's remember some of he says it's the press's fault, but then is he, I guess, criticizing us for putting his own words on television? Because yes, these are some of the nice things that he said.
Would I approve waterboarding? You bet your ass I'd approve it. You bet your ass. But it's political bullshit. Do you understand?
I would bomb the shit out of him.
They're bringing drugs. They're bringing crime. They're rapists.
We have this guy, Lion Ted Cruz. We know Lion Ted.
There's a guy totally disruptive, throwing punches. We're not allowed to punch back anymore. Like to punch him in the face, I'll tell you.
I don't know what I said. I don't remember.
Brian, nice and intelligent, and it's the media's fault for the perception of him?
Yeah, I would say this. I think the media does a job of trying to sort of portray Trump and his voters as less than smart, less than sophisticated. And so when he sort of pushes back at those things, he's defending himself, and he's also defending the voters. Let's talk about what he just did this past November. Nobody else has done that in American history. We spent less money. We don't come from any establishment political party per se. It's sort of this independent movement that come forward that manifests in the Republican Party. That wasn't on accident. That wasn't because Donald Trump didn't know
Brian,
how to
I understand. I understand what you're doing, but he could have said that today when asked. He's the one that brought it up, saying that his perception, right. He didn't bring all those things up that you're saying. That's not what he's talking about. He's talking about his perception, his own words on television. And a lot of that he said live.
That's what you should do. But like I said, when he's out there defending himself and defending his voters, that's what he's doing. The media is trying to portray this image of Trump and his voters as something less than sophisticated. And that's not the media's job. The media's job is
using his words.
So when Trump's out there defending, he's defending by the way, he's defending the electoral majority that brought him into the presidency.
So we shouldn't put his own words back on TV, too.
No, you should always use his own words, but you should always use them in the proper context and understand what he's doing.
BS or or mocking the reporter, or what's the context of that?
Well, the context is that the American public is frustrated with Washington, D.C. They think it's broken. They think the last 30 years has failed a lot of these communities in Wisconsin, Michigan.
I don't understand, Brian. I don't want to be rude, but I don't understand what that has to do with him saying nasty things and mocking people and coming up with nicknames. What does that have to do with that? And if the press points that out, how is that getting the perception wrong? How is that portraying him in a negative light? Isn't he doing, in essence, doing that to himself? If he didn't want that perception out there, then he wouldn't do it.
I think what you have done is you have sort of two parallel tracks here. You have him manifesting the frustration of the country, which is what he's doing, and he's speaking the language of, you know, the Americans and their frustration with Washington, D.C., and then you're trying to layer sort of another component on here that's sort of less than sophisticated.
I don't see a lot of people mocking reporters with disabilities and you know, calling people funny names a lot, but that's just me. Scott, you don't get a chance to get in. I'm sorry, because we're way into the next show, but I do have to say to you, happy birthday in about an hour or so, and Angela Rye as well. Happy birthday to both of you. I'll see you next time. Thank you.
Thanks, Don.
Thanks, guys.